Good morning everyone, I'm Gary. I'm actually the CEO of Mono & Co. Our company actually specializes on selling electronics products as well as cross-category products. So we are now into home and living, baby product, health and beauty, as well as fashion. We started this business about 4 years ago. I did it together with Adam, my co-founder of Mono & Co. He is in an IT distribution line, so he teamed up with me and he will source the supply. I myself will do the marketing. We started to do the online sales 4 years ago. Back then, a lot of people never even think about e-commerce at time, and a lot of people still believe in brick and mortar shops. During the beginning of our e-commerce journey, there are four things that is hamper our growth. Number one, sales. Number two, working capital. Number three, manpower. And number four is the trust of the distribution network. So for us to gain sales is quite easy for us because we have the expertise and we know how to navigate the e-commerce. Out of the four, the most difficult part is to gain the trust of the distribution network. For instance, a lot of distributors 4 years ago, they don't believe in e-commerce sellers. They only believe in people that have a shop and, you know, have a brick and mortar shop. Okay, the biggest difference between online and offline is the ability to make use of the data available to us on e-commerce. Take for an instance, if you are doing a shop right now, a customer comes into your place and buy a shoes from you. Do you know who is your customer? Do you know how to utilize their data? You can actually collect the data when they buy something from you, but they don't. So for us e-commerce, whenever we make a transaction, we got some data of the customer, which we can use to communicate with them again and again. You know, they can become a repeat customer or a loyal customer. As an e-commerce company, we communicate a lot with our customer. Okay, when we started out, we don't use any system. Our accounting, I remember 4 years ago, we were using Excel sheet. Very fast track, and our order has came up to about 36,000 order a month. So we realized that we need to have a system in place. You know, we have a lot of problem in fulfillment. We send the orders twice. We are, you know, being charged excessive shipping fees. So I agree, we need a system in place so that, you know, we can avoid all these problems. Okay, after our group has engaged PayRecon about 2 years ago, our company has become more agile and we can respond faster to the market need. We are able to take on a lot of orders compared to previous years. We've got to know PayRecon via their advertisement in social media. Our team contacted Sean from PayRecon and from then on started our collaboration with them. We started to use PayRecon in year 2018. That is the second year of our operation.
I'm Alfred from Mono Digital. So my company is in different marketplace, there are 10-20 different stores. Before using PayRecon, I would use different store marketplace 的 order 直接 key 落去 account system 嗰度。之前咧我就做嚟做去都做唔曬嘅，所以自從我用咗 PayRecon 之後，佢就將我以上嘅問題解決咗。尤其是唔同嘅 marketplace 或者唔同嘅 store 會有唔同嘅 code。當 key 落呢個 account system 嘅時候，都會有阻滯。自從用咗 PayRecon 之後，就將我以上嘅問題解決啦。佢可以 standard 所有嘅 code。除此之外，佢亦都好方便我哋 monitor 我哋每日嘅 sales 啦、 order 啦，同埋我訂貨嘅 quality.
One of the best features is the ability to scan your parcel before delivering out. This one enables us to reduce the mistake of being double sent. By using this feature, we can minimize the duplicate order being sent out. Number two, PayRecon is also quite on hand on the mailing label. They have the ability to custom design the mailing label for us. Why is it so important? It's because if you are a seller right now, I believe you know that, you know, a lot of time post like you cannot scan the barcode. You know, you can talk to PayRecon and they are able to enlarge, you know, and put in some features that you want into it. Thirdly is the multi-channel chat system. As our company is an e-commerce enabler, we manage a lot of other client accounts. I think at any one time we got 40-50 accounts, but our CS, before we engage PayRecon, we need to log in, log out each individual account. But by using PayRecon, we are able to check all the live chat in one single window, which is very good for us. Lastly is the AutoCount integrator. They have an integrator that has the ability to knock off. Our team no longer need to key in the sales one by one, knock off it individually. So I think these four features are very important to all sellers. Yes, of course, we will recommend all sellers to use PayRecon, no matter if you are a small, intermediate, or even an expert level of seller. They have different customized package for each stage of the seller. I believe all sellers will have the problem of, you know, calculating whether the shipping charges, is it excessive? You know, did Lazada or Shopee overcharge you or not? With PayRecon, you are able to now track very fast and accurately on the shipping fees overcharge. So I believe all of you should give PayRecon a try.